Yes, it's probably just a slight reskin with some tweaks. But if you look under the hood, it's very different. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Coldborough Farm. We're down at the shop where... Yep. And we're after renting a Case Puma 240 CVX. Because... I forgot to turn on trackhead again. Well done, Dave. Because today we're going to go baling. Now, these Wednesday videos... This is the Wednesday video. Dave is having trouble remembering what video it is already. Wonderful. These Wednesday videos, there's not going to be a poll. There's not going to be any kind of stuff like that. I'll just do what needs to be done. And we'll move on with the farm. So we've rented a Case Puma because there is baling to be done. I wanted to use something a bit different, so I got the biggest bloody tractor I could find. It might not necessarily be the biggest I could find, but I've got a big tractor. And we're gonna pick up the baler, which I can't remember where I put it. I think it's at the main farm. So if you look over there, you can see that field, field 21, yes, is not windrowed. Field 22, however, is all pretty and nice like. So I spent a bit of time doing that, and now I'm gonna go grab the baler, bring it over there, and get to the baling. So I'll be with you once we get the baler and stuff. So as you can see, I've got that windrowed up. I did use the... Why does that look funky? I used the New Holland windrower from the Small Farms pack, so got nice small windrows. For those of you who watch Simulate's channel as well, this baler is less likely to cannon than the John Deere and the stuff he uses. So let's unfold it. This is the Class Quadrant 1200. Really nice baler in my opinion. Let's get it switched on. And I'm going to start with the uppy downies because if I do the headlands first, I'll just make a mess. So this field is pretty much all going to go over to the pigs. The pig and beef area. Because we need to get mixed rations. We need to get them mixed rations, basically. And the plan is we're going to do... This here, we're going to make silage over at Yatton Ridge. And then we'll be good for hay and silage. And the silage is probably going to be the stream. I'll mow, windrow up with the two-rotor windrower, and then likely rent the JF stall thing. That's kind of one of the plans I have for the stream. I might do a field or two of... normal harvesting as well. But yeah, this doesn't cannon, it just kind of drags the bales along behind for whatever reason. But they are default in-game bales as far as I'm aware. I'm not entirely sure why this baler is not dumping the bales correctly. It might be something to do with the hill. But the big case is more than powerful enough to pull this baler at a reasonable speed. I think this is a reasonable speed for baling as well, so... There shouldn't be many complaints about, oh, you're baling too fast, or you're using too powerful a tractor. No. The New Holland can't really pull this baler, as I discovered. So, I'm just using a tractor that makes a bit more sense. And I know I should be skipping rows, but... There's not that many rows of hay to begin with, so... The second videos on each map during the week, there's going to be no pause, and it's just going to be me doing work that needs to be done. The TW10 I'm going to bring over, and I'm going to bring over the Marshall bale trailer. I'm going to stack manually and then just use the locking script to clean the stacks up and lock them down properly. I'm not going to cheat like I did last time I made hay. And just use the auto load script. No, I'm going to use it all, I'm going to do it all manually, and then just get it locked in. And for those of you who are bound to ask me to do round baling, no. I've had my fill with the round bales. I'm probably not going to do them again in FS15 unless it's on a perfectly flat map. The physics of round bales are just too wonky for me. You can see the lines from the New Holland Windrower, which that's surprisingly pleasant to look at. I must admit. As you can see, I was actually driving fairly steadily with it. You can see I also did the kind of inside third headland a second time. I actually did the three headlands, then went over the inside one a third time, or second time, just to clean up the ends of these rolls so that I could bale them a bit easier. And hopefully get no bales on the headlands, which was my fear. In theory, you should get this entire field baled in this video, which is nice. I won't start moving the bales today, because there's plenty of other stuff I could be doing, plenty of other stuff to do. And for those of you asking for shoutouts in the comments, that's not going to happen. Also, I'm just going to cover a few things, actually, just while I'm doing this. The first thing, those of you asking for shoutouts, that ain't gonna happen. I only really shout out channels that I like, so you know, you'll get the odd Daggerwind shoutout because I do like Daggerwind's content. You get Simulate's shoutouts because I do like Simulate's content and he's a friend. Funky Farmer, One Lonely Farmer to an extent. Don't agree with everything he says, but. And some of the stuff he says genuinely disgusts me. But, you know, that's how humanity works, and that's how a healthy discussion is. That said, I don't think he quite understands the meaning of healthy discussion, because whenever anybody agrees with him, he just flat out says, no, you're wrong. Learn the facts. That said, he's a Trump supporter, so I mean... I guess everything he says has to be taken with a pinch of salt. that's not me hating on him. I think he's a genuinely good, content creator. He does a lot of stuff that you wouldn't normally see. I guess it's really nice to see him out with the baler and talking about his big pack baler and all that kind of stuff. I just don't agree with some of the stuff he says. He's doing more of a vloggy style video. The Funky Farmer, obviously. I don't like all of his content, but you know, that's YouTube for you. Now, if you don't like a video of mine, that's fine. If you don't enjoy the odd video like this one where I'm just bailing, that's perfectly fine by me. You're not gonna like every video ever. And if you wanna get into doing YouTube, don't expect everyone to like every video. You know, I like certain styles of farming and I like certain things that I do. Don't particularly enjoy everything. Baling's one of my favourite things to do. Baling, mowing, windrowing, all that kind of stuff. My favourite stuff to do in the game. Harvesting to a certain extent I do enjoy because it's kind of relaxing. That's why I'm actually not averse to driving the Neva in the multiplayer. For those of you who were wondering why on earth I wanted to drive the Neva so much, I enjoy harvesting. The next trick is to get Simulate to drive that thing, but I don't know if I'm ever going to succeed because he does hate the offset style of it. The polls in the videos, guys. I don't mind you saying what you voted for in the comments, but if you just say... TNT does this. If you say, I voted for X, but I really want Y, well, then you voted for X. What goes into the votes in the poll itself is all I count. I do not count a damn thing said in the comments. Because, the way I say it, one vote per person as in a true democracy. You may have noticed that in yesterday's video I put extra cards in promoting my various other playlists. Same thing, I'll do the same in this one. And the reason is that was just so that it didn't end up with a duplicate poll again, because YouTube is a bit weird. Also, you know, it's about time I started promoting stuff on the channel of my own. That corner here is where I managed to get a perfect 90-degree bend with the windrower, and I didn't quite know how to deal with it, so I just kind of went, just cut a bit into it, and that'll be fine. And I missed a bit. That's fine. I don't mind missing small bits like that. So, we won't get a second cut before I swap over to GMK. Or swap back to GMK. And quite happily, I don't need to do a GRLE swap when I do that. It'll just be a straight swap. I may cultivate up the grass and just plant normal grass again, because I only put down the soil mod grass to suit soil mod and that and requirements of that, so I might replant normal grass, I might decide to put alfalfa in these fields, and you know, I'm going to leave options open because I'm going to do a raft of sweeping changes, well, not sweeping, but a raft of changes to the map, including, now I'm suddenly getting 60 FPS, interesting. I'm going to put a couple of extra crops in, which means the sheds will be a bit wonky. One crop is going to have to be only accessible from the main silo, which is a bit annoying. But that's the only way I can do it, unless I completely rejig the main yard, which that's a few hours of work, and I'm not really willing to do that. But yeah, the two things I'm going to do is I'm just going to put GMK back in, and put in some multi-fruit functionality of probably oats, rye, and alfalfa. Or actually, oats, rye, and clover. And the clover I'm literally just going to grow for silage. That's going to be a silage-only crop. Because that's, I think, all you can do with it. I think you can make silage bales with it, but I'm just going to chop it with... kind of mow it, windrow it up, then go over it with a JF or something like that. So this is going surprisingly well. Whoops. In terms of efficiency and speed, I'm efficient and speedy. For those of you who keep asking, and I don't know why, no, I don't live on a farm in real life. I don't work on a farm. There are farmyards near me. Well, there are fields near me. Oh, and there's a little update as well. I was saying all last week that the New Holland TF-78 that I want to get on here, that passes by my house. Turns out I was factually incorrect. For one reason and one reason only. The contractor or farmer who owned the New Holland TF-78 has upgraded to a New Holland CX-8090. I think it was a CX-8090. Which is significantly larger. It's got a 10,500 liter grain tank as opposed to 9,500 liter. It's got a slightly bigger header, and it's like 6 or 7 years newer. So I can completely understand why a contractor or farmer would upgrade from TF-78 to a CX-8090. That same. I'm guessing it was a contractor because they had a T. What T7 did they have specifically? It was a T7 220. So I mean, that was nice to see passing by my house when I was having breakfast one day. They were just after finishing the harvest itself, and hear some noise, and I'm like, oh, there must be a harvest or something coming down. Next thing, here comes a T7 pulling a. I think it was about a. 25 foot maybe header. Maybe it was an 18 foot. Pretty sizable header. And I said, oh, harvest was coming, I get to see the TF-78. Except I didn't realize that was a newer New Holland header than I was used to seeing. The old one, they used to have a Ford 7000, I think. So Ford's going to be happy to hear me talk about that. Ford 7000 pulling it. Now they're using apparently T7220, and it had to go back had to go back up to the field to get the grain trailer dumped. Because the grain trailer was empty, it was the last tractor in, so the first tractor out, and then first tractor back in. So the winter, I think it was winter barley they planted up here, is mostly harvested. There are a couple of fields still near my house that haven't been done. But the ones that require my... the harvesters pass straight by my house are done. I wouldn't be surprised if there's another cut of silage yet to come though, so... that'll be a fun few days when they're going mental with that stuff. Because when they're doing silage, my road once again becomes Farm Central, and it's very difficult to avoid seeing a tractor or six. Speaking of farms and farming, Simulator spoke about it in the stream yesterday. Yes, he did stream, so those of you who missed it, you missed it. Simulator spoke about it in the stream yesterday, pure farming. Still very little information available. We'll get information around 2 weeks' time, I think, after Gamescom. They said they'll be at Gamescom giving... they'll have a booth there, so there'll be more information at Gamescom, so I'm looking forward to finding out more about that. It does look very interesting. The publishers who have their own in-house development team working in conjunction with an indie developer, the publishers themselves have a pedigree. They've worked on the likes of Dying Light and Call of Juarez. Those of you who follow big games, they're pretty big games, as well as Dead Island. Yes, the same, that Dead Island, the one with the really cool CGI trailer that made it look like it was going to be an awesome game and then was just generic zombies. That was by them as well, or published by them at least. So it looks like the double to triple A, I know there's no AA games anymore, it's either indie or AAA, but it looks like the farming sim genre is kind of becoming a bit more mainstream, courtesy of the likes of PewDiePie and Nerdcubed and, you know, people like that kind of making fun of the games. They're getting more sales because, hey, you know, that's how I found Farm Sim. I was watching Nerdcubed and I watched them screwing around with Farm Sim 13, and I will openly admit, I pirated it at first, but then once I got some money, I bought it. And I realized I actually took the game seriously, and that's why I'm in Farm Sim 15 with a G27 and a joystick and head tracking. And fraps running on Audacity open. That's why I do YouTube, is because Nerdcube made fun of a game once and I actually really enjoyed it. not even kidding. So I'm hoping to get more than just today's video on today. More than today's video. I'm hoping to get tomorrow's video and Friday's video done as well. Friday's video, I actually want to get some mods into ATS, which is going to be fun. And Saturday's stream is probably going to be American Truck Simulator. Simulator has said that he's planning on doing some ETS2 streams when his internet is less bad. So I'll probably be joining in on those streams as well. Yes, I'll play some Euro Truck. I'll have a bright pink Scania or something. Pretty in pink trucking is worldwide, yo. And for those of you who are wondering why I'm still doing ATS videos, because I'll admit they don't get as many views as Farm Sim, I really do enjoy making it. Yeah, I really do enjoy American Truck Simulator. And I think the multiplayer is really good for the streams. I want to start modding it so that I can get some really funky looking trucks. to paint hot pink. not even kidding. Somebody did send me a link to a hot pink Scania in Farmsum, or it was either a man or a Scania, could have been a DAF, I guess. He sent me a link to a hot pink truck mod for Farm Sim. So what I'm going to clean up the field a bit. Get rid of some of the scraggly bits of hay I missed. Because I am OCD, yo. Simulate does the same thing, so you can't complain if you watch him as well. Do you know what? No, I'm just going to call it there. I'm just going to stop the baler. Empty it out. That one bale is, there we go. Let's fold it back up. And we're going to keep it down here because I do want to bale the other field with this as well. This setup at least. I don't know how many bales I've got there. Except to do, if I press Alt H. 63 bales, that's quite a lot. So maybe we do return the case. Yeah, I think we're going to return the case and just bring the quadrant baler back up to Coldborough. Bullet Bill, by the way, is back working on Coldborough Farm in real life. I believe he said he lives in Ross-on-Wye again or something, or in that area at the very least. So he is releasing some videos of Coldborough Park Farm. And I don't mean the map, he is releasing some real life, actual real world Coldborough Park Farm videos. As you can see, we're no longer in Schrodinger's edit. I've put the forgotten fruits textures back in for wheat and barley. So they look, I'm just going to stop up here. They look really nice. They go quite well. I didn't swap out the distance texture, so it kind of fades a bit weirdly, but I think it actually looks quite nice at a distance. Where can I put the baler? I guess I can go back in where it was. Put it in beside the corn harvester. For those of you who are voting corn on Monday's video, because I have a sneaking suspicion you don't realize what my corn harvester looks like. Because there seem to be a few comments saying, oh, you should harvest corn, thinking I'd be using the Lexion. No, that's not a thing. This is my corn harvester, the SIP Tornado 40. It's quite small, isn't it? Now that I haven't really used it properly, it does look like it works. It's pretty cool to work with. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clean the case here. So I'm just going to call up the guys at the shop and tell them they can come collect their case. Return the vehicle. Yes. We're going to hop over into New Holland. Just randomly teleport. Get her turned on. Attach up the... Is this like a PTO shaft? Or I'm not entirely sure. Attach the little shaft on there so that the wheels are driving the tether, windrower, sorry. And we'll start windrowing this field. Now, I won't do it all on camera today. I'll do the first headland, really, because this is quite slow. We're only going at 11 kilometers an hour with it. I'm just going to do the first headland. We are going to use the SIPMA baler on this field because the local stables for horses, they've told me they need bales. They want me to provide them with hay bales, so I am going to do that, and we'll probably be doing that in next week's video or the week after. We'll be doing that in the very near future, is baling this field up with the SIPMA, collecting up whatever bales we get, and just popping them into shed so that they the local stables can pick them up whenever they want. The reason I'm using this windrower, as opposed to the big two-rotor one that I have, is because I want to take my time today. I'm having a bit of a chill time. I think this windrower looks nicer when you use it on hay, because all of the hay windrows I've seen, they tend to be quite... Well, in Ireland and usually the UK, traditionally they've been quite small and quite thin lines in between them. Just because, well, not really quite small, but they've been thin lines between them. I'm kind of considering getting a different grass and hay texture in, because I can do that. I'll fix it all up and get it going. I'll probably use the hay definition from Littletown, because that looks really quite realistic. So that's the outer headland done, or the outer bit of the first headland. So now we have to drive on the hay, and we're gonna start over here, I think. So the reason I'm now on the hay is because I want the windrower to run the other way, and this only ever works one way. It's like one of the single rotor ones. All this does, and there are videos of this online, videos of this all over YouTube, it's the New Holland 258 rake. Literally all it does is it just kind of pushes the grass over to the side. It doesn't fling it at all, so the little animation's kind of a bit wrong. It doesn't fling grass, it just kind of rolls it over to the side. But it gives really nice looking windrows. As you can see, the grass is quite healthy. We've got nice green going on under the hay, so I don't care about graphics in a simulator. I really don't. I play the likes of GTR 2 and stuff like that. I play R-Factor. You know, graphics are only important in so much as you can make out what you're supposed to be driving or what you're supposed to be doing. They don't have to be pretty. They just have to be functional and have good physics. For them, you know, graphics do have an importance, because you at least need to make out what you're doing. And it never hurts for something to be pretty, but at the same time, it's not the be-all and end-all, like some people are claiming. You know, the biggest complaint about FS17 is it looks like FS15. I don't care. Yes, it's probably just a slight reskin with some tweaks, but if you look under the hood, it's very different. FS15, as it currently stands, is using OpenGL rendering, which is very, very memory intensive. It's very bad. It's an old standard. FarmSim 17 is moving to DirectX, which means number one, minimum requirements are going to be not that much different for FarmSim 15, the requirements to play it. And number two, and this is important for the likes of me and Simulate and Dagowin and Bill's T-Max and Dirtevers and Stucco Gloss, people who play the game, you know, Fresh Eggs, Sean Blaylock, Bipolar Prophet. Especially those of us who record with Fraps, specifically, so definitely me and Simulate. Fraps will no longer crash if we accidentally click outside the game, which it currently does, because it's trying to pick up an OpenGL layer, and OpenGL doesn't run when you're not focused on the game. So that's problematic. DirectX kind of does, it's just better in general. Big question is, what DirectX version are they going to use? Are they going to use DirectX 11 or DirectX 12? Because I doubt they're going to use DirectX 10. But I'm going to call that a video, guys. I only meant to do one headland, I'm onto the final one already. I'm going to call that a video here. I'm going to finish windrowing this up off camera. Don't forget to, if you haven't seen it already, watch Monday's video, number one. And vote the poll there for what you want to see next Monday. This video obviously has no poll. The midweek videos won't have a poll. Wednesday and Thursday videos. Just because they're a bit more difficult to record. Record with polls, because I'm planning on doing these kind of in a bunch. So, I've been Rainbow Dave. Well, I'll leave you now by saying I've been Rainbow Dave. You've been watching Farming Simulator 15 on Coldborough Park Farm. Until next time, stay safe and always do the electric boogaloo.